The British Army in North America was too small to continue the occupation. In the end, the main forces of the American Army, supported by 5,000 French troops and the fleet, surrounded the enemy at Yorktown, Virginia in October 1781. Some 14,000 strong American and French troops, significantly superior in number, laid siege to the British positions. Recognizing the hopelessness of putting up a resistance, Cornwallis requested a truce on October 17th and signed the surrender 2 days later. The British opposition had broken down. In 1783, they signed the Treaty of Paris, whereby the colonies were accorded independence.
We'll be right back.
As a result of successful military operations, Britain acknowledged the sovereignty of the American colonies. In 1783, they were forced to sign the Paris Peace Treaty, according to which the United States obtained their independence. After the end of the war, George Washington was elected the first president of the USA by an overwhelming majority. Washington took up the post on April 30, 1789, and was re-elected in 1792. Under Washington, the territory of the state expanded fast. As a result of a deal with Spain, the borders of the U.S. and Spanish colonies followed the 31st parallel, which created excellent conditions for the conquest of the Wild West. In 1791, Vermont, a new northeastern state, was annexed. Kentucky followed in 1792, and Tennessee in 1796.